Hello guys, welcome to my channel or welcome back. So today we are making a hanging pocket holder from a shopping bag. Here I'm using a cotton based, a jute based shopping bag. In case you don't have the same type of material, then you can go for any other material as well. For me, it is easy to sew in the sewing machine when it is a cotton or a jute material. That's why I'm using this. In case you don't have a sewing machine, you can very well stick them together. So in that case, it is not required to be a cotton shopping bag. You can use any other material as well. So what I'm basically doing is cutting a strip out of the shopping bag as a base canvas, and then I'm using an old pant cloth to cut out the pocket pieces. To make the base of the pockets, I'm cutting out a semicircle out of the same cloth. First of all, I'm marking the actual edges of the base and I'm giving some seam allowances here, and I cut through the seam allowance lines. There's going to be three pockets in the hanger. I'm sewing the neck part of the pockets here. So for making the base, I'm going to connect the square piece with that of the semicircle. As you could see, I'm keeping the right side facing each other and stitching from the wrong side. Basically, I overlay the edges of semicircle all through the edges of square. For a closer view, I'll show it again. So by now you would get an idea like how does the pocket going to look like, and I'm here showing you the details like how does it get connected. I do leave an inch gap at the beginning of the stitch, and then I'm sewing all through the edges of semicircle with that of the square's edges, and then again leaving an inch at the end. To basically start off and to be on the line, I'm joining the center of semicircle with the center of square piece. After which, I'm starting from the middle and sewing all the way through the edges. As you could notice, I'm leaving an inch gap at the end, and then I'm turning around and making the remaining half stitches here. Then I do overlock the edges of the canvas or the shopping bag. Then I'm marking a semicircle out of a cardboard. This is to make the base of the pocket sturdy. So later in the video, I'll show how to get it stuck with the pocket. So now I'm joining the base, which are the seam allowances I have mentioned earlier, with the shopping bag. I do sew twice wherever it is needed. So once it is stuck, it will look like this. Now I'm stitching the seam allowances we left on the square piece. So I'm folding it over once and then sewing along the edges. And the same way on the other edges too. As you could see, I'm turning the ears of the shopping bag into two different loops. So for making the hooks on the pockets, I'm going to make a tassel here is our tassel ready. After which I'm going to keep the cardboard inside, for which I'm making a loop out of a masking tape. I'm using a masking tape here because when I need to wash the bag, I can very well remove the cardboard. Then I'm decorating with some borders here, decorative laces. As I'm running out of any decorative materials due to the lockdown, I couldn't find any other lace to decorate it up. After which I'm sewing a button, and then from the tassel I'm making a loop and I'm joining that with the cloth as well. Usually this is how I secure the knots at the back. So we are done with our DIY hanging pocket holders. If you like this idea, then please give it a thumbs up. If you get to sew the pockets using a sewing machine, then it will be handy to store any remotes or kids' toys or a bundle of woolen threads. So that's how I'm going to use the holder here. And if you like my channel, then please do consider subscribing to it and turn on the bell notification. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one. Bye.